palms pressing equally into each other, just a little bit of pressure from each hand. We're going to use a hasta vinyasa throughout our practice today, just to link our poses together. Hasta vinyasa, hasta means hands, and vinyasa is that link between the movement and the breath. So for today, we're going to use what's called the circle of joy. To start out with, you're going to take an exhale. Join the fingers together and press down right about the height of your diaphragm. On your inhale, you're going to lift up to the chest, pull the elbows out to the sides. On your exhale, press the knuckles out front, round through the spine. So inhale, sit up straight, flip the palms up to the ceiling. On your exhale, release the arms, circle out to the sides, bring the hands behind the back. We'll interlace the fingers behind the back. Inhale, lift your chest up. Exhale, sink the shoulder blades down. On your next inhale, sweep the arms out to the sides and up. And exhale, down to the heart. So full deep breath in between. That one more time. So it starts out interlacing the fingers. Exhale down to the diaphragm. Inhale up to the chest. Open out through the elbows. Exhale down to the front. Scoop the belly in. Inhale, straighten up, palms flip up to the ceiling. Exhale, nice open circle. Draw the thumbs back as the arms come down. Behind the back, interlace the fingers. Inhale, lift the chest. Shoulder blades draw down the back. Then the inhale, we circle the arms out to the sides. So we're still drawing the thumbs back through that opening to the chest as we reach up. Palms join together, exhale down to the heart. Let's take that breath one more time. Starting out on your exhale, interlacing the fingers down to the diaphragm. Inhale up to the chest. Lengthen up through the spine, palms flip up. Exhale, opening the arms as wide as you can to drop down. Inhale, lift the sternum, lift the heart up. Exhale, shoulders relax. And then next inhale, nice wide circle, come up. Exhale, lift the heart. Releasing the hands, let's straighten the legs out. Starting out in staff pose. Taking the hands right along the sides of the hips, pressing the palms down into the floor, spread the fingers out. And as you're pressing the palms down, try to draw the shoulder blades down the back and flatten your shoulder blades against the ribcage onto your back. Feeling that length out in opposite directions. We're sending length out through the soles of the feet. We're sending length out through the crown of the head. This as our down dog pose. We're just kind of flipped over on the back. But that's the same action that you want to get when you're in your down dog. It's that same lengthening. We're reaching down through the heels to ground to the mat. We're reaching out through the crown of the head to get that length in the spine. Now let's take our inhale, sweep the arms up. Exhale forward, fold, reaching out of the legs. Length through the upper body. And one of the things that you can think about is trying to lengthen out through all four sides of the body. So left and right side of the torso, and then also the front and the back of the body, especially through the belly. If you have length through the belly, you know. should be. So with your exhale, see if you can relax the knee closer to the floor.
Okay.
side bend. Keep the right side of the hip anchored down on your exhale. Think about pressing your right side low down. Use your inhale to come up to sitting. We'll open into that twist, draw the right arm back. Exhale, come back to center. Pull that into the left leg. Keep the lower back.